Inside the engines of the Army's Black Hawk helicopter, it's more than a little hot. Temperatures can reach more than 2,500 degrees Fahrenheit, making the need for strong materials a must. At the U.S. Army Research Laboratory, scientists are on the hunt for new materials that will change the world in a big way.
What we're seeing is a revolutionary property arising in a class of materials that we never thought was possible.
Darling and a team of collaborators published a paper in the journal Nature that outlines the discovery of previously unknown properties of metal nanostructures that can maintain strength at very high temperatures.
It's a very unique finding in that it takes what is currently known about the material systems that I work in and sort of flips it on its head and says that things that people thought were impossible are possible. We did the preliminary test here. We didn't get what we were expecting. And so a lot of times unique discoveries are made on accident or by sheer luck. And this was one of those cases where we started to probe the material and we didn't see the response that we were expecting. And from there, all the excitement sort of grew, and we started doing more thorough studies, and then ultimately led to this writing this paper. The results are pretty, I would say, they're shocking in the sense the behavior is so much better than what you would expect from a material like this.
This is an alternative way to make a material that may lead to large advances in high-temperature turbine engine applications.
The DoD heavily depends on jet turbine engines, both in the Army, Air Force, and, of course, the civilian. And any other sorts of high temperature applications, gas engines or anywhere that you would need to have high structural strength with high thermal stability. We are at the right point in the right time, and I think it's exciting. I think it is almost sort of like a renaissance period of getting to the point where we can now make these materials. It possibly could open the door to revolutionizing engine technology, which would be benefit for the Army as well as civilian applications, I guess.
Darling said they hope to improve the properties even further by understanding how to manipulate the microstructure. For ARL TV, I'm David McNally.